Hello everyone! Today I will be showing you how I made this light up mask using the LilyPad Arduino. It was part of a mini collection for a fashion show that went towards my final project at fashion school. All of the information that went into making this will be in the video, in the description, and also on my blog. With the right materials, this is actually quite an easy project, even if you're not very familiar with programming. This is actually an updated version of a design I came up with when I was like 16 in high school. It was quite a long time ago. The lily pad is on one side, the battery pack on the other, and then there's six LEDs in the middle. The LEDs themselves are connected to three different pins on the lily pad, which tell them to blink at different times to run a sequence. I used the exact same process of making the mask as I did with making the jacket. It was just a little bit larger in scale. For all the electronic components that are needed to light it up, you will need a battery pack. This one holds a AAA battery, but there are other ones available. You'll also need various LilyPad LEDs of choice, conductive thread, and the LilyPad Arduino. The LilyPad Arduino is a microcontroller that will be programmed to tell the LEDs what to do. You connect the LEDs to the LilyPad using the conductive thread. These are actually the exact same components that I used to make my original mask all the way back in high school, so they look a little bit worse for wear, but they work exactly the same. And it's kind of the beauty of the LilyPad because you can reprogram it to do different things and make different projects. But in order to program this kind of LilyPad, you will need a special cord which plugs into the USB to your computer. You'll also need to have your face mask pattern cut out and ready to go. Technically, I'm making two masks, as the outside one will have the lily pad attached, with the other one being a removable lining that you can wash. Both patterns will be on my blog if you would like to use them. You will also need some elastic for ear straps too. Begin by making little darts in the top and bottom of the mask. This is just to make it a little easier to shape around the face. Then sew around the edges of the mask with a 1cm seam allowance, leaving a small opening that you can turn it through. Before turning it through, clip your corners so they are very sharp, then end stitch the mask so it sits nice and flat. This is the mask once it is finished and ready for the lily pad to be attached. The fabric placement was done to specifically work with my circuit design, but this can be changed around depending on the fabric that you want to use. You can also see how the black lining fabric is just a little bit smaller to be invisible when seen on the outside. And before we start on getting into making circuits, I'll just go over it briefly. I am by no means an expert in electronics, but I haven't had an issue before with the circuits that I've made. To make the lily pad light up an LED, you need to do three key things. The first is to connect the battery pack to the lily pad with the plus and minus pins. Then you need to connect the plus sign of the LED to a numbered pin. Then you need to connect the minus of the LED to the battery pack, then it should work. Another thing to remember about the LilyPad circuit is that the conductive thread cannot cross over itself or it will stop the circuit from working. Once you have the basics down, you can start to add more LEDs to more pins, with the only difference being that the little minus of the LED needs to connect to the same string leading back to the battery pack. So this is the circuit I'm using for my mask. It has three separate pins, with each pin being attached to two LEDs. You can play around with this setup with more LEDs or less, so long as the circuit is complete with no crossovers. Once I've planned out the circuit, I do like to also program the lily pad at that time, just so I know that I'm getting the sequence right as I'm making it. The software I use is Arduino IDE. It is free to download, and there is a preset basic blink code that you can load up. More info on how to program the lily pad is on my blog, but the most important thing is to put your pin numbers here, put whichever pin you want to light up here, write the duration you want it to light up for, which is in milliseconds, and then put the same pin number here for when you want to turn it off. Repeat that a few times, and now you have a blink sequence. Once you've checked that it works, you can upload it to the lily pad. Before making the final mask, I made a little mock-up version which makes it easier for me to see how big the components will be and where is the best place to sew the thread. Once you are all ready to sew the lily pad in, you will also need a hand sewing needle and some regular thread along with the conductive thread. Sewing with conductive thread is a little different to normal thread, mostly because it is very coarse. I like to use a needle threader to get it through the needle, double thread, knot it as well as you can to make sure that it doesn't come apart. I like to start by connecting the lily pad to the battery pack first. Start by looping the thread around the pin a few times. Make sure to start and finish your thread in a way so that it doesn't touch more than one pin at a time, otherwise this will cause problems with the circuit. There's two ways to sew the conductor thread. One is with a backstitch, which creates a distinct line of thread and is probably the most reliable way to sew it, since there will be more thread for electricity to flow through. If you don't want to do backstitch for everything, I would recommend doing backstitch for only the battery pack connecting wires and then a running stitch for everything else. The main issue I've had with the LilyPad is not having a strong enough connection between the LilyPad and the battery pack, so backstitch solves that quite well. Once you get to the battery pack, loop your thread around the matching symbol a few times and cut off the thread. Sewing in the LEDs is pretty much the same as the battery pack, just make sure to match to the right symbols. If you run short of thread, you can knot it off and start a new thread, but they will still need to connect in order for the circuit to work. I usually change thread when I get to an LED, so I can loop it around another time before continuing. If you ever feel unsure about how your circuit is going, just do another test with the alligator clips to make sure everything's functioning as intended. Once everything's sewn in, just try it out. Before I put it on though, I attached some small snap domes to the mask and lining so it would stay in place and comes off very easily. And to ensure that the thread would not unravel in the future, I dabbed a little bit of clear nail polish on the knots of the conductive thread and anywhere else where I thought it might come undone. And here is the finished mask. I love how easy it is to reprogram something like this. The mask itself is pretty comfortable to wear. The battery pack isn't heavy and it sits comfortably. Another great thing about the LilyPad is that while there are basic rules to go about using it, there are other versions available, such as other battery packs I haven't tried, along with buzzers, accelerometers, and other things you can use to make fashion that functions very differently to this. At the end of the day, this is just a demonstration on just one of the ways that the LilyPad can be used in fashion. Like I said before, I used the same process to put the LEDs into the jacket, which was also part of my collection. I had two LilyPads for the jacket, so one for the front, one for the back. I taped everything down and sewed it as I went, so it was a pretty easy process. So there, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day. I hope this was educational or interesting in some way. If you end up using this technique, let me know. I would love to see it. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Bye!